Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another review from Pinnacle Studio Pro. It's your boy Malik holding it down once again for PinnacleStudioPro.com. Alright people, with all the devices out there that you can use to hook up your films using your iPhone or your iPad to capture video, it is about time that I brought you some love from the Pinnacle Studio iPad and iPhone app. Let's get into it. Here we are in the loveliness that is the Pinnacle Studio iPad and iPhone app. Let's get this review underway. First thing we need to talk about is the interface. The interface of this is so clean and beautiful. It's just simple to use. When you first open up the app, this is what you'll see if you have any type of projects that you have set up. Otherwise, it'll be blank at the top. Now, the few different ways that you can open up a project. You can double tap or any other plus signs in that film strip in the middle of the screen. It'll let you name a new project. You also have the option of tapping on the start a new project icon, and it'll bring up the same option. The other things up here on the toolbar, the first thing you have is the ability to import a project. You can import from several different online services such as Box, Dropbox, Google Drive. You see all the names on there. It is important to mention that you can only import Pinnacle Studio iOS file formats into the app. You cannot import your Pinnacle Studio desktop or laptop program projects into the app. All right, just the ones for iOS. Then you can rename your project. If you don't like the name, you can say, I hate this freaking name. Rename it. You don't like it, you got the option. You also have the option to duplicate a project. Now, what's cool about that is if you use some titles or transitions or some of the media, you want to use it again, but you don't want to mess up the other project, you could just duplicate it and go in and make the changes to the second project. Real cool. You also have the share movie and transfer project icon. You can share your movie after it's completed to YouTube, directly to Facebook, Vimeo, and those other cloud services that you see on there. And then you can also transfer your project files to the cloud. Now, for this option, if you transfer these from the iPad app to the cloud, you can import those into your desktop or laptop Pinnacle Studio application and continue editing there if you wish to do so. Snazzy, real snazzy. Right, and if you want to clear up some space, you're done with a project, you've shared it to wherever you want to, you have it saved in the cloud, you can delete a project as well by clicking on the trash bin. Just select the project you want to delete and click on it. Yes, I do really want to delete this project. Then you also have your settings. So in your settings, you got several different options here. There's a pop-up menu that you can pull up, and it'll tell you what each and every icon is for so that when you tap on it, you know what you're going to do. You got your support forums and your video tutorials. Now, these are brought to you by the developer, LumaTouch, who worked with Pinnacle Corel to make this wonderful app that you see in front of you. You also got your project defaults. You can change the photo duration. You can change the title duration. You can change the transition duration. Then you can also add automatic transitions. What that does for you is if you add a clip behind another clip, it will automatically add a transition so you don't have to go add them in yourself. You also have your default volume. Now for your app settings, you can change the resolution of your preview. You got several different resolutions on here that you can change it to. You can change your default frame rate. Several different options on that as well. You can maintain your audio pitch. So if you want to change the speed of a clip and you want to maintain the audio pitch, you can do that here. You can reset any marked library clips that you have. Then you got your special options. You can clean up temporary files, rebuild your media library, and restore purchases from iTunes. And if you want to know all of the people who put in the hard work to create this app, you can just click on the credits or tap on the credits and you can see them there. Let's jump off into the app. So I'm going to tap on start a new project. And let's name this project. And tap OK. Now we're in the building. First thing you see in your media window over to the left is that you have all of your media already imported from the device into the Pinnacle Studio iPad app, and that's real snazzy. Then you have your preview window to the right, so you can use this to look at the video. You can tap on anything and it'll come up on there how you like it to. Below that you have your actual storyboard, and then below the storyboard you have your timeline, and below your timeline you have your audio timeline. So we'll talk about those a little bit here in a few seconds. All right, first thing let's do. So over to the left, you have all your different media that you can access. Let's start off with the home button. That just takes you back to the screen we were on previously. Then you have all videos. This will show all the videos that you have on your device that you've imported into the iPad app. If you tap on albums, it'll break it down by album. So if you have several different albums on your device and you want to narrow down your search, you can go to a different album and select from there. Same thing for events. If you have it broken down by events, you can go to different events and find your media that way. Then we have photos. Once again, you got all photos. If you have them recognized by faces or albums or events, once again, you can go ahead break down the looks. If you got a bunch of pictures on your phone or on your iPad, this is a great feature for you to streamline your search and find things in the different albums that you save them in. Then we have songs, so all the songs that you have, same thing, you can break it down right underneath that by artist, album, playlist. Then you have effects. There's a bunch of effects that come with this app. So you got animals, background noise, cartoons, explosions, fires, all types of great things. Effects that are free. Free sound effects. Go figure. Then you have your transitions. So your transitions, you can use a transition from one photo to another video, or video to a photo, or whatever you want. You got basic, you got pushes, you got slides, all types of different transitions. Then you got titles. So you got motion titles and standard titles. So these titles basically can be changed as far as the font, the color, the position, the size, all those things you can change right here within the app. And then we have what are called theme packs or montages. What these are is you can think of them as quick ways to make a movie. You can drag them into the timeline and then drag any photos or pictures or sound or music, and it'll help you create a really professional looking movie that you can share with your family, friends, or whoever you like. Now, a few things that I want to show you real quick before we go. Two more things, really. Let's drag a clip down into the storyboard. When you drag a clip down into the storyboard, a representation of the size of that clip is automatically added to the timeline. I'm going to go over how to edit these things in a future video. Just want to bring this down here so I can show you a few things. Once you have this down here, you have some other options here at the top. The first option is, once again, you can share your movie. So it's really easy to do. You can share your movie or transfer your project once again. Then you have the option to go full screen. So if you tap on that icon, you get a full screen view of the video that you can watch. You can tap on it again. Double tap it and it goes away. And once again, you have your settings. So all of your settings you can change. You can change your frame rate. You can change your durations on a lot of the different options. The only thing you can't change at this point is the resolution. You got to set that up before you get started. Let me just say, this is a great app, all right? Y'all know I love Pinnacle anyway, but this app is on point. when it comes to using your iPhone or your iPad to take videos, take pictures, do whatever, if you want to be able to put together a snazzy movie easily, quickly, and be able to share it with people, bring it back to your studio and do things on your editing software at home, this is the app to get. Jump up on it.
All right, guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments. If you leave me questions, I'll give you answers. If I can't find the answer, I'll point you in the right direction to get you the help that you deserve. If you need some more Pinnacle Studio love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe. Hit the little button on the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on.